The force of nature known as Jamie Foster Brown is a writer, interviewer, television producer, magazine publisher, international consultant, moderator, speaker, and now doctor, having received a doctorate in humane letters from Bennett College. Dr. Brown, okay, Jamie, hails from the Windy City, Chicago, Illinois, and after graduation from Calumet High School, attended the University of Stockholm in Sweden. There, she and her husband, Lorenzo, raised two sons, Randall and Russell.
Went back to, came back from Sweden, and I was scuffling around to see how I can get started. What can I do? I've always been ambitious. A national organization of women that has grown up since I had been away, you know, Gloria Steinem and all of them, you know, they were killing it out there. I went, my girlfriend that I knew down in Birmingham, she was performing for them, and I went to her concert, and she said, Jamie, you always had the personality to be like an agent or something. Say that you're my agent. Be my agent tonight. If people come and ask for me, you know, you'll be the one that take down the information. And I did. The first thing I did in the entertainment industry was do group sales for colored girls at the Warner Theater in Washington, D.C. And that's how I kind of got into this.
When she returned to the state, she founded the Washington Theater Group, a service group focusing on theater group sales. Later, she worked for Black Entertainment Television as an advertising secretary to its founder, Robert Johnson, and was subsequently promoted to producer for their flagship shows Video Soul and Video LP. In 1988, she founded Sister to Sister magazine as a monthly trade newsletter targeted at prominent women in the entertainment and media industries. Within 10 years, Sister to Sister was hailed as one of the most respected entertainment magazines with a special focus on African-American celebrity news.
One of the things I have a problem with, because with my publication, Black artists always want you to write just the good things about them. But white mainstream papers can write anything about them, and they'll still go back to that mainstream paper. But if the Black paper says something bad about them, they're just like, oh, I'm not going to talk to you anymore. So that's something that Black press has to deal with all the time, because it doesn't empower us to help them even when there is something that goes wrong.
As the popularity of Sister to Sister magazine grew, Jamie created a syndicated radio show, the Sister to Sister Celebrity Update. This program was heard on 39 radio stations across the nation and aired on the BBC in London. She extended her readership in 1998 when her tribute book to Malcolm X's widow, Betty Shabazz, A Sister's Friend's Tribute in Words and Pictures, was published by Simon & Schuster. Like many pioneers who have broken new ground, Jamie has won numerous accolades as a trailblazer in the entertainment industry. And her talent, tenacity, and toughness made her one of the most prominent Black women in entertainment journalism. She was honored with the Lifetime Achievement Award by the Midwest Radio and Music Association, the Support Network, the Anheuser-Busch Eagle Award, Martin Luther King Jr. Scholarship Award for Outstanding African-American Women, and the Impact Super Summit Award. She was entered into the Congressional Record as one of the most accomplished and respected women in the field of entertainment journalism. And to top it off, the mayor of Washington, D.C. officially named August 18, 1998, Jamie Foster Brown Day. Since the 2015 death of her beloved husband, Lorenzo, Dr. Jamie Foster Brown has been working on the next chapter of her story. Buckle up, world. You're in for an amazing ride.